Yeah, I first started listening to Pearl Jam in high school, and like everybody else, when that album, when 10 came out, just immediately became a disciple of their music, and really it's like a big turning point for me and the music I was listening to, because up until then, I've been listening to a lot of heavy metal and rock and a lot of 80s hair bands, and those guys came along and just turned everything upside down, and became a huge fan. And actually the song that I'm singing tonight with Mike McCready and The Roots, Alive, is probably one of the first songs that I ever really got turned on to, and I've probably listened to like a billion times, so pretty crazy to be here tonight, get a chance to sing that song. We were, our tour ended December 7th in Las Vegas, and we've been, you know, touring really hard, probably did like 300 days that year on the road. And I knew that Pearl Jam and U2 were playing in Honolulu on December 8th, so I had this scheme of getting my band and crew and all of us flying down to Hawaii to kind of have our first official day off from the year, and watch an epic concert, two of my favorite bands of all time. And we went down there, and it was just such a killer show, both the guys, Pearl Jam and U2. And afterwards, the hotel I was staying at, Mike was staying there, so I went over and approached Mike, and that's how this whole friendship kind of began. And through the years, we've collaborated on different things. I think one of the first things we did is I played a show in LA at the Troubadour, and had a bunch of different people from different kinds of music backgrounds being there, different genres. Paramore was there, Dwight Yoakam was there, and a bunch of folks. But Mike came out and played some Johnny Cash with us that night. And later on, he came to Nashville, and I got him to play on a record of mine, play on a song. And I think the last thing we did was in Seattle, we did Record Store Day together, playing, I played Just Breathe, which is a song I've been covering in my kind of bluegrass part of my show. We did that, we did a Graham Parsons song. So we've done some stuff together in the past, but never really live or on TV before. So I was so excited to see him when he showed up for soundcheck. Just in the nick of time, he actually popped in just for the solo on the soundcheck. It kind of freaked me out because I had my eyes closed. I looked over and all of a sudden there was Mike. But just a crazy way that the friendship started, and just a huge fan, and I can't wait to go out there tonight and put some stuff down for the books.